this big European tour instead? I don't know, you've been holed up at home, haven't you?
Yeah, I have. It's a real shame. Obviously, we all know that everyone's health and safety comes first. But we were thinking, when we had to postpone the tour, we thought, well, what can we do to thank fans for being so patient and for all their support? So we actually thought, hey, you know, we have all this footage that we've been capturing over the past 7 or 8 years, and why not put it together as an album? So that's what we've done.
So the album is called Live Around the World, and really it shows this amazing relationship that you have with the band. And I suppose it all started, what, around a decade ago when you were a contestant on American Idol. We're going to have a quick look at that now. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race. That must take you back. Do you ever pinch yourself to think just how far you've come?
It's pretty wild. You know, if somebody had told me that the things that I had done on American Idol would kick off, you know, the next decade of my career, I would have not believed them. You know, it's been such a blessing. And I feel like Brian and Roger are just brilliant. They're incredible musicians. They're incredible gentlemen. And I've learned so much working alongside of them.
With the band, you've played to almost 4 million people. 4 million people around the world, an absolutely staggering number. On our programme, we've been talking a lot about the live music business and what will become of it, because, of course, so many people have lost their jobs because of it. What are your fears for the industry?
Well, I mean, it's just that. I just hope that we can get this vaccine situation sorted very soon. I know a lot of people, in fact, people that we employ on our tours, you know, people that work behind the scenes, people don't have work right now. So I'm hoping that this speeds along.
Yesterday, we were talking about our Chancellor of the Exchequer, who was suggesting that people in arts and entertainment need to adapt and evolve. But of course, it's not really that easy for people, is it, in the performance sector?
No, and it's, you know, if this is your livelihood and your career, it's not a hobby. It's not just something you can just, you know, throw away. It's what we know as artists. I think, obviously, if you have to make money, you have to make money. So, I mean, there's some truth in that comment, but it's a lot more complicated than that.
Okay, on a more upbeat note, what's next for you then, Adam?
I'm doing a lot of things. You know, I'm trying to take advantage of this downtime and create. I'm actually here in London at the moment working on a musical. I'm co-creating it with some amazing people. I'm writing music all the time. I'm voicing an animated series. I'm busy, trying to stay creative.
Keeping busy is good. Adam, lovely to talk to you. Good luck with the album. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.